반갑습니다.
So good to see
네,
you.
스타마스터 김은혜입니다.
I'm the Star Master Grace Kim.
저는 애터미의 로얄 리더스 클럽에 있습니다.
I belong to Royal Leaders Club in Atomy as well.
로얄 리더스 클럽 다들 아시죠?
Do you guys know that who's qualified to be part of the Royal Leaders Club?
네. 애터미에서는요, 연봉 2억 이상의 멤버들을 로얄 리더스 클럽이라고 해요. 근데 저는 애터미를 선택해서 이 자리까지 왔고, 또 지금의 제 모습이 바로 앞으로 여러분들의 미래의 모습일 거라고 생각을 합니다.
So yeah, for Royal Leaders Club, the qualification, the requirement is that your commission has to be more than about 180,000 USD per year. But I've been doing Atomy and I was able to be join for the Royal Leaders Club and above. And so, but hopefully, but this will be your future. It's not only my life, my reality will become your future in the future.
여러분은 왜 애터미 하세요? 이렇게 질문하면 바로 대답할 수 있으세요?
So can you guys answer like if somebody asks you why are you doing Atomy?
전 이게 굉장히 중요하다고 생각을 해요.
I believe this is the reason how you can answer why it's really, really important.
저의 why는 이것입니다.
Because this is my reason why I joined Atomy.
워렌 버핏은 당신이 잠자고 있는 순간에도 수입이 나오게 만들지 못하면 당신은 평생 일해야만 한다고 이렇게 얘기를 했죠.
Because this Warren Buffett that he said, if you don't find a way to make money while you're asleep, and you will work till you die.
저는 워렌 버핏이 말한 잠자고 있는 순간에도 돈이 나오는 시스템 소득을 간절히 원했습니다. 그래야지만 제가 원하는 삶을 살수 있겠다는 생각이 들었기 때문이죠.
Because I really, really, really wanted to find the way, the system income so that I can make money while I'm in sleep.
그러면 저는 잠자고 있을 때도 수익이 발생을 할까요?
So do you think like I made the system that while I'm in sleep, I still can make money?
네, 이게 저의 수익 그래프인데요.
Yeah, as you can see, this is the commission growth, the graph.
저는 지금 잠자고 있는 동안에도 돈이 나오게 만들어 놨습니다.
So now, yeah, I really made that my income as that I it really comes in while I'm in sleep even.
코로나19 동안에 이제 그 수입이 떨어지신 분들도 계실 텐데, 저는 애터미를 만나서 성공의 법칙과 습관에 몰입한 결과 이런 기적의 주인공이 되었습니다.
So yeah, I know many people in the worldwide that because due to this COVID-19 that like a lot of business went down. However, during this COVID-19, it didn't affect on me. It even went up higher.
이건 제가 시작했을 때부터 지금까지 6개월 정도 수입을 평균으로 나타내놓은 거예요.
And the reason why it went up even it's because I followed the Atomy system. And then as you can see, this is like each time the half of the year that I made it as the average of it.
제가 2013년도 봄부터 사업을 시작을 했거든요.
Since because I started this business like since the March of the two year of 2013.
그런데 계속 이렇게 성장을 하다가 지금 보면은 2020년 하반기 코로나 기간 중이죠. 가장 많은 성장을 했죠.
So as you see, like my income was like continuously growing, but then as you see that during this COVID-19 the pandemic, then it really, really went up straight.
애터미를 통해서 마르지 않는 통장이 생긴 거예요.
So it's basically like through Atomy, I made an like bank account that it never, never dropped.
코로나가 이어지는 동안에도 수입은 계속 늘어나고 있는 기적을 경험하고 있습니다.
So this is like a miracle that during this COVID-19 but my income is continue growing.
이건 제가 7년간 애터미 시스템에 들어와서 저만의 파이프라인을 구축해 놓았기 때문이겠죠.
And I believe it's because last 7 years that I've been in Atomy business and I've been building Atomy my own the pipeline in Atomy.
하지만 애터미 하시는 분들 중에도 코로나 기간 동안 어렵다는 분들도 계시고, 저처럼 성장한 분들도 아마 계실 겁니다.
But you know, I know that some of like people who've been in Atomy also like me, but they some of them like their sales have went down, and then some of them like feel like it's not easy to get over this COVID-19.
누군가는 성장했고 누군가는 성장하지 못했다면 성장한 사람한테 특별한 노하우가 있어서일까요?
But however, some group have grown bigger than before. Then do you think like there is a special reason why for those people how they were able to grow bigger during this COVID-19?
저는 어떻게 이렇게 코로나 기간 동안 성장을 할수 있었을까요?
How come I was able to grow bigger during this COVID-19?
지금부터 제 이야기를 한번 해보도록 하겠습니다.
So I'm going to share with you the how I was able to grow.
제가 정말 자신 있는 게 하나 있어요. 그게 바로 긍정적으로 생각하는 거예요.
There's one thing that I'm really good at this, and that is thinking in positive way.
어떤 분들은 코로나19 상황을 애터미 사업의 장애물이라고 생각하시는 분들도 있었을 거라고 생각을 합니다.
I believe some of you, like some people, like they are taking this COVID-19 is as like something that will make everything drop, everything down.
하지만 저는 이 위기가 기회라고 생각을 했습니다.
But for me, this crisis was like seemed like an opportunity.
그리고 이 시기에 더 빠르게 움직이는 자가 더 앞서갈 거라고 확신했습니다.
And furthermore, if I can boost up a booster during this period of time, that will bring me more bigger success.
아마도 제가 성장할 수 있었던 가장 큰 이유는 코로나19를 불안하게 이렇게 받아들인 게 아니라 이 상황에서도 할수 있는 걸 그냥 찾아가지고 했던 게 아닐까 싶습니다.
So I believe like instead of like taking like this COVID-19 as crisis and then like taking this as like a biggest concern and worrying about it, and I was taking this and I was accepting this as the opportunity, and that's why that I was able to continue on what I'm supposed to do.
나무가 흔들리면요, 앉아있던 새들도 날아가죠.
So, have you seen any, like, if one tree is shaken, then all the birds, little birdies, like, were sitting on the tree will fly away.
리더가 불안해하면은요, 파트너들도 흔들립니다.
So, if a leader is, like, kind of, like, feel, like, uncomfortable, like, very insecure about things, then the partners, they will know, like, they will feel it right away.
코로나19 초반에는 센터가 문을 닫고 시스템이 없어지면서 파트너들이 많이 위축되어 있었습니다.
So, it was same to me, like at the beginning when the COVID-19 strikes and at the beginning time, the center was not able to open up. And then so I can feel the most of my partners like feel very, they were very, they feel very insecure about things.
이럴 때일수록 스폰서인 내가 더 정신을 바짝 차려야 된다라고 생각을 했습니다.
So, but that brought me to thinking stronger because I'm a leader and I'm a sponsor of everyone. So if I'm like I show them like that I feel insecure as much as they are, then it will be not nice.
상황을 객관적으로 바라보고 어떤 장단점이 있을지를 생각해보고 고민을 해봤습니다.
And so, I try to see this situation as objective as much as I can, and then was thinking about like what how I can get over it.
코로나19뿐만 아니라 애터미 사업을 하다 보면 아주 많은 여러 가지 상황들이 생길 수가 있습니다.
It's because, when you're doing like throughout your Atomy life, like there must be some times that it's like some oh like you never expected like what will happen to you.
여러분들이 애터미 사업에서의 속도는요, 어떤 일이 터졌을 때 그거를 막 감정적으로 처리하기보다 객관적으로 상황을 판단하고 어떻게 처리하느냐에 달려 있는 것 같습니다.
So, you know, but I believe like whenever this kind of like some issue happens to your group, instead of taking it as emotionally, I think like I recommend you to take like to practice to see the what is the issue and how you can solve it.
내가 우울하고 짜증내고 있다고 상황이 해결되는 건 아니니까요.
Because when you're mad and you're depressed, like expressing those emotions doesn't help, doesn't solve the issue.
코로나는 피할 수 없는 상황이었고 급한 거는 전 시스템이라고 생각을 했습니다.
So, you know, since this COVID-19 happened to everybody, and then, but yet I had to create the, I had to continue on the system.
매일매일 돌아가던 센터 교육이 없어졌기 때문에 오프라인 시스템을 대신할 온라인 시스템이 필요했고 온라인 교육 센터를 만들어야 되겠다라는 생각에 유튜브를 시작을 했습니다.
And so because, you know, like since we, before that, like with the center that we had a system that was like, we had like some lectures and sharing every day. And, but then yet because of this COVID-19, we were not able to do that. So I tried my best to bring it to the online. And so that's why I have started the YouTube channel.
근데 저는 유튜브를 원래 할 줄 몰라요.
But you know what? I'm not good at it. I never thought that I will really do the sharing in the YouTube.
지금도 올리는 방법도 몰라요.
And still now, I don't know how to upload any video.
그런데 저의 장점이 제가 뭘 잘하고 뭘 못하는지 잘 안다는 겁니다.
But another my strength is because I know that what I'm good at and what I'm not good at it.
온라인 교육센터를 만들어야 하는데 나는 유튜브를 못하고 그래서 제가 못하는 부분을 빨리 처리하고 도울 수 있는 사람을 찾아봤죠. 근데 제 동생이 있었습니다.
And so, yeah, since I had to create the new online system, and but then I don't know how to do this, how to utilize those YouTube channel, and so I was looking for the people, and then I found out my brother can really help.
웹 개발자인 동생한테 많은 조언을 얻었고 제가 이제 하고 싶은 방향을 설명하면서 센터에 있던 모든 시스템을 온라인으로 옮겨 보기로 했습니다.
So because since he was a web developer and so he was able to help me. So I told him that what kind of like direction and what kind of things that I'm looking for. And so that's how I started like to changing all those offline system to the online system.
근데 여기에서 또 난 유튜브 못 하는데 유튜브 하라는 거야 또 이러신 분들 계실 수도 있어요.
Okay, but you know, I'm not asking all of you to do this YouTube channel, so don't worry.
제가 여기서 말하고 싶은 건 여러분들이 할 수 있는 걸 찾으라는 거예요.
So the point of why I'm sharing this story is like you need to find, you need to look for the what you can really do.
분명히 유튜브로 열심히 하고 있는 사람들이 있을 거예요.
Because I believe that among some of you, like there must be some people who's already sharing some on your own YouTube channel.
그리고 지금 코로나19 이후에 애터미에서 온라인 시스템을 정말 많이 만들고 있거든요. 그래서 그런 걸 활용하시면 됩니다.
And then also, if you're not good at it, it is okay. But you know, since this COVID-19 threw out, then all those HQs and branches, they're really focusing making some kind of YouTube like online system for you guys, like online ODS, online Success Academy. So just using it, like it is totally okay. You don't need to make your own.
온라인 시스템의 장점은요. 센터는 계속 반복 교육을 해야 됐지만 유튜브 콘텐츠는 하나 잘 만들어 놓으면 반복적으로 쓸 수 있다는 거였어요.
So actually the biggest attraction to me in the YouTube using this YouTube channel is like for the offline center meeting, I had to like repeat and repeat and repeat again that what I have said. And but in YouTube, like once I put up one contents, then like I don't need to do that again.
근데 단점은요, 만나서 신뢰를 쌓는 인간관계 사업이었는데 만나지 못하니까 비대면 생활 속에서 또 대면을 찾을 방법이 필요했습니다.
And but you know, but also, but the one of the weakness about this using this YouTube channel was because actually Ultimate Business is all about the human relationship. And so we've been like before that, during the offline system, and we were able to meet each other at the center. And so we were able to build a trust through it. But in online system, we were not able to do that. So I had to find a way how I can make this on-text system to the contact system.
일단 1대1 미팅과 소규모 사업 설명회는 원하는 분들이 한해서 이제 파트너 사장님의 학원이나 스터디 카페 같은 데를 이용해서 소규모로 진행을 했습니다.
So first, like if I were like there are some people that who wants to have like small meetings, that I was able to do that, like meeting with some people with like using some seminar rooms and yeah, like that.
그리고 또 코로나19로 이제 바뀐 상황을 전략적으로 잘 활용했던 것이 또 제 사업이 성장하는 원동력이 되었던 것 같습니다.
And also I believe that I found more opportunity throughout this COVID-19 pandemic.
코로나19를 위기로 생각하는 사람들을 찾아가서 이제 그들의 니즈를 들어보았습니다.
So, you know, I was actually visiting like those people like who feel like who's very insecure about this because this COVID-19, and then I was looking for them more, and then I like, gave them the opportunity of the Atomy business.
한국은 코로나19 전보다 코로나19 이후에 새로운 일을 찾는 사람들이 굉장히 많아졌다라는 게 되게 피부로 와닿았는데 다른 나라는 혹시 어떤가요?
So I'm not sure about the other countries, but in Korea, how I felt is like after this COVID-19 pandemic throughout, in Korea, there are more people who are looking for a new opportunity than before.
근데 또 제가 사는 지역 외에 전국, 그리고 전 세계에 많은 파트너들이 있잖아요. 그런 미팅에 또 한계가 있었습니다. 그래서 제가 시작한 게 이제 줌 미팅이었습니다.
But you know, I realized that like yeah, I was able to still meet up some people like near me, but I also had a partners like throughout entire nation, and then also I have some members from abroad.
지금도 이렇게 우리가 줌에서 엄청 여러 나라 사람들을 만나고 있잖아요.
So I started like using the Zoom meeting, and so just now today we are meeting. I'm meeting you guys through this Zoom.
지금 여기에 인도 분도 계시고 호주 분들도 계시고 호주는 지역마다 시간도 다 달라요. 그리고 원래 여기가 말레이시아 팀 미팅이거든요. 말레이시아 분도 계시고 필리핀 분도 계시고 여기저기 이제 여러 나라 한국 분들도 계시고 여러 나라 분들이 들어와서 지금 함께 하고 계십니다.
So yeah, today we have some people from India, even Australia, and even, you know, people in Australia, they all have different time slots, but still here. And then also people from Malaysia and people from Korea, like whole various of people are in here today.
이런 오프라인 시스템의 부재는 온라인 시스템으로 해결을 했고 또 줌을 활용해서 화상회의 시스템을 만들다 보니까 전 세계의 파트너들이 시스템에 들어올 수 있도록 이제 되었습니다.
So because I was able to make this create that this YouTube channel, so it was able to replace this offline system, and also at the same time I was using this Zoom meeting, so all the meetings were able to cover, but even the abroad market was able to cover.
그동안 제가 이제 전 세계 전국에 퍼져 있던 파트너들 때문에 고민했던 부분이 오히려 저는 코로나19 이후에 이런 한계를 느끼던 부분이 온라인 시스템 통해서 해소가 많이 되었습니다.
So frankly, you know, before this COVID-19, I wanted to meet up all those my members all of the around the world, but I couldn't because of physically there was a limit and time-wise it was limit. But because of this online system, now I can meet anybody at any time.
성공 노하우를 물어보시는 분들이 굉장히 많아요.
So a lot of people actually asking me how were you able to manage that?
근데 사실 저도 노하우라고 말하기도 부끄러울 정도로 그냥 평범한 과정을 통해서 성공을 했다고 생각을 합니다.
So, but actually, there is not much of like special secret for that. I was just like doing what I'm supposed to do.
특별한 방법은 없는 것 같아요.
I can tell you there's no special secret for it.
그런데 제가 할수 있는 건 그냥 다 했던 것 같아요.
But I did everything that I was able to try.
그리고 긍정적인 분위기를 잃지 않기 위해서 노력한 것. 그게 아마 저의 성공 노하우가 아닐까 싶습니다.
And also, I really, really, really tried my best to keep the atmosphere as positive as much as I can.
코로나19로 힘이 빠진 건 우리의 소비자가 아닙니다.
So actually, it's not about our consumer that who fell down during this period, during this COVID-19 pandemic.
오히려 소비자는 온라인 쇼핑몰에 몰려들었습니다.
So, you know, instead of like they going down, they are more focusing into the buying things on online.
근데 나 자신이 혹시 다운되어 있는 건 아닌지 한번 되돌아보시기 바랍니다.
So I want to ask yourself, isn't it you who feel down about it?
양자택일을 알아서 해석하세요. 2021년 애터미 사자성어가 양자택인데 제가 아주 가슴에 와닿고 좋아하는 말이에요.
So in 2021, that in the Atomy's new slogan is the genius of the end. And I know it is not easy to understand. And this means if you have like you are not, you know, most of times we are looking for the when we have like two options, we are able to only choose one option, right? But instead of that, we are going to no matter what, we're gonna take both options with us. So that's why just like the killing two birds with one stone.
유튜브나 줌으로 미팅을 진행하느라 오프라인 미팅에 소홀하신 분들이 있습니다.
So there are some people like who are more focusing into the online side, so their offline meeting is like not that it's not that important anymore for them.
하지만 온라인만으로는 한계가 있기 때문에 만날 수 있는 사람은 만나야 하고 특히 소비자는요, 오프라인으로밖에 컨택할 수가 없습니다.
So, but I believe that like there is like some people you should meet as offline, and some parts that online can cover, and there are some parts that offline must cover.
소비자와 사업자 당연히 둘다 만들어 나가야 하고요. 제품 전달, 비전 전달, 당연히 둘다 해야 됩니다.
And then, of course, we need to continue make some agent under your business partners, and then also you need to at the same time you need to continue on making consumers.
국내도 해야 되고 해외에서 사업도 해야 되고 또 강의만 하고 미팅만 하는 게 아니라 현장도 직접 내두 발로 뛰어야 합니다.
And also, yeah, we need to deliver the product, and then at the same time, we need to deliver the vision. And then also, you cannot just remain with your domestic market only. You can go, or you need to take care of your abroad market. And then also, we cannot just be with like listening to lectures and attending meetings. We need to go on the field and meet up new people.
저는 제가 열심히 해서가 아니라 저는 그냥 하던 대로 했는데 다른 사업자들이 위축이 돼서 상대적으로 제가 성장한 것처럼 보인 게 아닌가 이렇게 생각을 합니다.
So, you know, how I feel is like I didn't really do like not much of like difference. Like after throughout this COVID-19, I didn't do much difference than before the COVID-19 happens. I was just doing same things. But while like other people were like not doing anything, but I was just continue doing things. And so it seemed like I have grown bigger.
애터미는 내가 어떻게 해서 성공하는 게 내가 어떻게 잘해서 성공하는 게 아니라 제품과 글로벌 원 시스템 그리고 무한 단계, 무한도전 시스템 때문에 성공할 수밖에 없게 만들어져 있어요.
So, but you know, in Atomy, as long as you're continue doing it, and because of its system, its products, and its global one marketing, and the no registration fee, no monthly maintenance, all those things will make you, no matter what, successful in Atomy.
그냥 시스템에만 앉아 있다고 또 성공하는 것도 아니에요.
But like even but. That doesn't mean you are just within the system only doesn't mean that you can be successful only.
시스템에 앉아 있으면서 내가 할 수 있는 걸 다 열심히 하다 보면 내 능력 때문이 아니라 이 애터미가 나를 성공자의 자리까지 데려다 주는 거라고 생각을 합니다.
So within the system that you just try whatever you can do and then you continue doing that, then at some point that you will become successful within Atomy.
결론적으로 여러분들의 능력이 중요한 게 아니라 애터미는 누구나 성공할 수밖에 없기 때문에 여러분들이 할 수 있는 걸 찾아서 최선을 다하시면 된다는 거예요.
So as a result, as a conclusion, that is, Atomy is anyone, every of us got opportunity to be successful, and its system is made it for it. And so you just need to try, and you just need to do what you're supposed to do.
얼마 전에 본사에 갔다가 대표이사님하고 같이 식사한 적이 있었어요.
And so, yeah, a few days ago, I've been to the HQ, and so I got to speak with our president.
제가 해외 지사의 문제점에 대해서 좀 이야기를 한 적이 있습니다.
So, and I was talking, what we were discussing was the abroad market.
근데 그때 대표님께서 저한테 이렇게 말씀하시더라고요. 애텀이라는 회사가 잘해서 잘 되는 게 아니야. 제품, 글로벌. 이 두 가지 때문에 회사가 완벽하지 않고 사업자도 완벽하지 않아도 누구나 되는 거지. 이렇게 말씀하시더라고요.
Yeah, actually it's because I told him that some branches like they are too lousy. They are not doing like they don't do the good enough service. And then you know what our president said, you know what? Like it's not about the company in Atomy. Like it's not that special that what company was doing that made the success. The success that Atomy was able to have it is because of its products and its global market, that non-limited market continue coming in.
여러분 정말 애터미에서 성공하고 싶으세요?
So I'm asking you, do you really, really want to become successful in Atomy?
제가 정답을 알려드릴 수 있는데.
I can tell you the secret how you can become successful.
근데 이건 제가 말한 게 아니라 임페리얼님이 말하신 거예요.
But actually, you know, this is what the Imperial Master Lee said, not me.
제가 애터미 사업을 시작했을 때 이더브 임페리얼님 강의를 듣는데 그분이 이렇게 말씀하시더라고요. 애터미에서 성공하는데 방법이 있다, 정답이 있다 라고 말씀하셨어요.
So, you know, when I, right after I joined Atomy and I was able to listen, attend the Imperial Master Lee's lecture, and then he said there is one way that you can become successful in Atomy. Only one answer for that.
이더 임페리얼님은요, 성공의 8단계 순서대로 오토 판매사의 방향으로 에이코어 리스트를 작성해라. 이렇게 말씀하고 계십니다.
So, you know, what he said was, follow the 8 steps of success to the direction of becoming the auto sales master. And but while you are doing that with the 8 core checklist.
저는 철저하게 이 강의를 제가 사업 시작한 지 한 두 달 정도 됐을 때 들었거든요. 근데 그때부터 지금까지 거의 7년 반이라는 시간을 철저하게 이걸 지키면서 전 사업을 했어요.
So you know what? Like I got to hear about this lesson from like this thing from the Imperial Master. Like I think it was like after 2 months after I joined Atomy. And so, you know, since then I followed this because I really wanted to be successful. And so for last 7 years that I've been doing, I've been just following this only.
많은 분들이 애터미 사업 어떻게 해요? 어떻게 하면 성공할 수 있어요? 물어볼 거예요.
And yeah, I'm pretty sure under you, a lot of people will ask you like, how can you become successful in Atomy? How to? What should I do?
그러면 성공의 8단계 순서대로 오토 판매사 방향으로 에이코어 리스트 작성하시면서 하시면 됩니다. 이게 정답이에요.
So the answer that you should tell your downline that asking you how can I become successful is you need to follow the order of the eight steps of success to become the auto sales master and then with the checking yourself with the eight core checklist.
방법을 찾는 사람은 많지만 실제로 알려줘도 실천을 안 하더라고요.
But you know what? Actually, most of us here, we all know about it already. But so many people know, like they are all looking for the method. They are all looking for how to do it. And but that doesn't mean they really practicing it, like practically following that actions.
성공의 8단계 순서대로 오토 판매사의 방향으로 가는 건 어떤 도구를 사용해서 어떤 방향으로 가느냐 하는 문제고요. 에이커 리스트 작성은요, 실질적으로 내가 행동을 하고 있는지 안 하는지 체크를 하는 거예요.
So you know, eight steps of success is some kind of like a idea of the method that we should have, and then becoming a auto sales master is our like kind of first goal. And but this eight core checklist is like eight actions that you should follow. Then it guarantees that your success.
이더구 임페리얼님은요, 에이코 리스트를 작성해 오지 않으면 상담도 해주지 말라고 했어요.
So even so, Imperial Master Lee told me, if your partner doesn't bring along the eight core checklist with them, then don't give them any counseling.
왜냐면은 에이코 리스트가 있어야 이 사람이 사업을 어떻게 하고 있는지, 무엇을 못하고 있는지 체크할 수가 있는데 진단을 할 수가 없으니까 상담도 해줄 수가 없는 거죠.
It's because without a core checklist, you don't know what that partner have been doing. And so you don't know like what is weakness of that person, what is the strength of that person. So we don't know what is weakness of them and what is strength of them. So we cannot say like, we don't know how to evaluate like what he have done.
여러분들은 성공의 8단계 순서대로 A core 리스트를 기본으로 하면서 보름간 좌측에 250만 포인트, 우측에 250만 포인트를 발생하도록 만들어내는 일을 하시는 겁니다.
So to be successful in Atomy is you are doing the following the eight steps of success while you are checking this eight core checklist, and then make sure that you are your PV accumulation of PV on your left side and right side to hit up 2.5 million and 2.5 million. That is all about this business.
자연 매출이 이 정도, 250만 포인트, 250만 포인트 정도 올라오기 위해서 내가 해야 할 일들을 생각을 해보세요.
So think about like if your auto sales that like sales that comes up under you to fill up to 2.5 million, 2.5 million PV, what do you really need to do?
성공의 8단계, 오토 판매사, 에이코 리스트 이 강의는요, 100번씩 들으셔도 됩니다.
And then I highly, highly recommend you to listen about eight steps of success and eight core checklist and auto sales master, those lessons, three of them. You may hear more, over 100 of them and it is still worth it.
100번씩 듣고 내 머릿속에 각인을 시킨 다음 행동하셔야 돼요.
So like after listening 100 times of it and then like so like feel it in your heart, deep inside of your heart, and then like you can really do the business.
제가 성공의 8단계와 에이코리스트 강의를 반복해서 할 건데 이제 그거 유튜브에다가 이 통역한 걸 올려놓을 거니까 그것도 참고하셔도 되고 이제 영어 번역본 같은 거 찾으셔가지고 좀 반복적으로 들으시기 바랍니다.
So I know there's a lot of like contents about those eight steps of success and eight core checklist and also the auto sales master that they actually made in providing in English and other languages. And then also I'm going to share this today's meeting to our YouTube channel. So please feel free to check on that.
아까 조금 전에 제가 말씀드린 250만 포인트, 250만 포인트의 방향이라는 게 바로 오토 판매사의 방향이겠죠.
So yeah, think about like once you hit up 2.5 million PV on your left and 2.5 million PV on your right, then it means your auto sales master ready every month.
우리가 씨를 뿌리고 잘 키워서 수확을 거두는데 그때 250만 포인트, 250만 포인트의 결실을 맺도록 농사를 짓는 거라고 생각하시면 됩니다.
So, you know, this is very simple concept. It's like a agriculture. Like, so basically you've been placing a lot of seed around you, and then you're going to harvest it. And then what you're going to harvest it is 2.5 million PV on your left and 2.5 million PV on your right.
나무 심는 거랑 비교해서 얘기를 해보자면, 나무를 10개 심는 사람하고 100개 심는 사람이 있다면, 당연히 100개 심는 사람이 열매가 많이 맺힐 확률이 높겠죠.
So think about you are raising some trees. Like compared to there's one person who's raising tree for 10 of trees only. And then there's another person that who been raising for 100 of trees. How much the fruits they are going to get? Do you think like the person with a 10 tree will get bigger amount of the fruit than the person that who's raising with 100 of the tree?
그러면 당연히 이제 회원가입 많이 시키고 많이 알리는 게 당연히 좋을 겁니다.
Let's bring that. Let's apply that in Atomy. So, if you have more partners, more consumers, more registration, and more partners, more sales, then it means your business is growing bigger.
그런데 가입수보다 중요한 거는요, 어떤 나무의 열매가 얼마나 열리느냐인 거예요.
But you know what? It is not about like just number of the registration. You know, some trees brings more fruit than others.
열매가 곧 매출이라고 생각해 보시면 됩니다.
So let's say this fruit is equivalent with the sales.
사과밭에 사과나무 묘목을 심었다고 생각을 해 봅시다.
So let's say like you have a field of the orchard of the apple. Yeah, orchard of apple.
처음엔 모든 나무들을 똑같이 관리를 하겠죠.
So first, yeah, you will take care of every single trees, right?
모두 잘 자랐으면 하는 마음으로 가꾸겠죠. 여러분들이 모든 사람이 파트너가 됐으면 하는 마음처럼.
Because, yeah, you want all of them to grow like same, like grow big. So you take care of every single thing. Just like you want to have all the people you registered, all you wish that then they all become your partners, right?
근데 나무가 성장하는 동안은요, 어디서 열매가 많이 열릴지 알 수가 없어요.
But frankly, you know, while those trees are growing, you don't know. You don't know the which tree will brings you the most apples.
열매가 열릴 때까지는 알수 없죠.
Till the apple really show up, you don't know.
근데 나무가 이렇게 자라면서요, 성장 속도의 차이가 좀날 거예요.
And but I believe like there while those trees are growing, you can see some trees are growing faster and some trees like growing slower.
이때부터 더욱 관찰을 잘해야 돼요. 누가 더잘 자라는지.
And so, you know, the farmers should see an analysis like which tree is growing bigger and which tree is like getting stronger. You will see, you need to see that more carefully.
잘 자라는 나무, 덜 자라는 나무 모두 최선을 다해서 관리를 해주다가 이제 관리할 게 너무 많아져가지고 나 혼자 전부 다 관리하기 벅차지는 순간이 와요.
Because you know, like so you see like oh which tree is good, which tree is good, and but then at some point all those trees it's gonna be out of control.
어떤 나무에 손이 더 많이 갈까요?
So then once it's out of control, which tree that are you going to check more?
당연히 잘 자라는 나무가 관리할 게더 많습니다.
Of course, the bigger tree, stronger tree that you will get to see it more often, aren't you?
그래서 여러분들 입장에서는 소실적보다 대실적이 일할 게 많은 게 그것 때문이에요.
So, you know, like frankly, that is why always there's more work to do with a bigger leg than the smaller leg.
여기에서부터 고민이 오는 거죠. 잘 자라고 있는 나무를 냅두고 못 자라는 나무를 관리해야 되나? 어떻게 해야 되지? 이제 고민이 오실 거예요.
But I'm pretty sure, yeah, that will make you like thinking, oh my gosh, like what should I do? Like I know I should see those like smaller trees, but there's a lot of things to do in a bigger tree. And then what should I do? Like you may fall in those dilemma.
근데 잘 자라고 있는 거지 아직 결과물은 없어요. 열매가 맺힌 것도 아니고. 그런데 일단 여러분들은 여기서 우선순위를 정하셔야 됩니다. 내가 관리하는데 한계가 온다면.
So, but I want you to think like I know like it is like not the it, you don't know that still you still don't know because the fruits are not ready yet and so there's no result at all. But you need to think carefully that what you need to do to make those trees to grow bigger.
잘 자라는 나무들이 열매가 많이 맺힐 확률이 높겠죠. 그래서 잘 자라고 있는 나무들부터 우선적으로 관리를 해주고, 그리고 남는 시간에 나머지 나무들도 관리를 해야 되겠죠.
So, you know, I want you to set some priority after you facing this time. So, since you know, like bigger tree will be the stronger and then they will give you the better fruit than the smaller ones. And so you need to prioritize those trees as according to what you've been seeing.
보통 집중적으로 관리를 잘하면 집중적으로 관리한 사과나무들은 많은 결실을 맺어줄 가능성이 큽니다.
So, you know, after if you look into more on those trees, the bigger trees, then they will give you the bigger fruits.
근데 만약에 내가 무리해서 모든 나무를 관리하려고 했거나, 혹은 잘 자라는 나무는 잘 자라는 것 같아서 냅두고 못 자라는 나무만 관리를 했다면 어떤 거 하나도 제대로 못 컸을 수도 있어요.
But you know what? I'm going to tell you this. Like, if you were the one that who wanted to take care all the trees instead of making those priorities, or like you are just focusing on those small trees only so that they can grow bigger, and then because those bigger trees seems like they're growing well, so you are just leaving them alone. Like if you're like doing that way, it may kill all the trees.
오늘 제가 한 이야기를 지금 집이시겠구나. 오늘 제가 한 이야기를 곱씹어서 잘 생각을 해보시고, 농사 짓는 것과 성공의 8단계를 연결시켜서 한번 생각을 해보세요.
So today, I want you to think really carefully. I want you to think more deeply because I want you to relate this story about this farmer for the apples and with the 8 steps of success.
그러면 아마 여러분들이 회원가입하신 분들, 소비자, 사업자분들 중에 어디를 더 가서 관리를 해야 될지, 어디에 더 집중을 해야 될지가 조금 보이실 겁니다.
Then you were able to differentiate like who should I visit more often? Like who should I put more focus? You can prioritize the who is who.
매출 체크는요, 꼭 하셔야 되는데요. 매출 체크는 한 달이 지나면 못 해요.
So yeah, I want you to check your own sales every day. And because, you know, after a month, we cannot see the group purchase every day anymore.
매출 체크는요, 사과나무의 열매나 마찬가지죠. 그래서 열매 맺는 정도를 파악하는 기준이 된다고 생각하시면 돼요.
So this is basically like checking your sales means that how much fruits that you were able to collect.
매출이 있는 곳에서 어떤 결과물을 얻을 가능성이 높기 때문에 되도록이면 15일, 보름간, 1일부터 15일, 16일간 말일, 이렇게 보름간 기준으로 매출 체크를 반드시 해주시기 바랍니다.
So I want you to check your own sales like during the first half of months and second half of months because that's the most important period of time in alchemy. And so you then that way you can see yourself that where you at.
여러분 매출 체크도 하고요. 여러분들 밑에 파트너나 소비자의 매출 체크도 하셔야 돼요.
And then it's not only your own sales, like you need to see that what like a consumer under you, how much PB it comes up and how much PB that you have put down.
지금 당장은 매출 체크를 해도 뭐 보이는 게 없을 수도 있어요.
Yeah, you may not able to really write down any sales at the moment.
제가 말씀드렸죠. 이거 보름 한달 지나면 못 보기 때문에 지금부터 꾸준히 해줘서 그 결과 기록들을 모아 놓으셔야 돼.
So, but you know, I told you after a month you cannot check this anymore. So, if you write it down every day now, then after a month you can see entire thing.
그리고 그걸 바탕으로 내가 어디를 집중해서 관리할지를 결정을 하고 스폰서하고도 매출을 가지고 상담을 하시는 거예요.
And then based on that, with that, you can have the counseling with your upline. And then based on that, yeah, you know where to visit and who to see.
그리고 이더브 임페리언께서 코로나19 이후에 가장 중요하게 꼽은 게 에이코어 리스트거든요.
So, you know, actually the Imperial Master Lee said the most important thing to do during after ever since this COVID-19 pandemic, it is about Acor checklist.
저희가 지난달에 Acor 리스트에 대해서 좀 자세히 했었죠.
So actually last month like we had this Acor checklist with the details.
Acor는 나 자신부터 관리하면서 성공자의 습관을 만들어 주는 거예요.
So Acor checklist is basically like changing yourself to have the habit to a habit of the successful people.
이걸 여러분들이 파트너들한테도 복제를 시켜야만 해요.
So you must duplicate this to your downline as well.
Acor는 애터미의 성적표이고요. Acor가 완전히 습관이 되신 분들은 성공자가 될 준비가 되신 겁니다.
So Acor checklist is basically your grade report, your grade report and in Atomy. And so once you're fully you're filled up with 100% then that means you're ready to become successful in Atomy.
우리가 병원에 진료할 때도 문진하지 않으면은 처방전이 못 나가잖아요.
So you know when you go see the doctor then the doctor will ask you like those kind of questions and then they check it and then based on that they can give you some prescription.
마찬가지예요. 에이코어 리스트가 없으면 여러분들의 사업의 상태를 진단할 수가 없어요.
It's just same thing. So without this Acor checklist like I cannot tell you that where you at.
이 에이코어 리스트대로만 여러분들이 행동하시면 성공을 안 할 수가 없습니다.
So, you know what? If you take those all eight actions on the Acor checklist, there's no way that you will fail in Atomy.
네. 다음 시간에도 제가 또 성공의 8단계 에이코어 리스트 하나하나 또 자세하게 설명하면서 해 나갈 테니까 여러분들 일단 에이코어 리스트가 습관이 안 되신 분들은 이거부터 하셔야 되는 거 잊지 않으셨으면 좋겠고요. 여러분들 모두 애터미에서 성공하시길 바라면서 오늘 강의 마치도록 하겠습니다. 네, 감사합니다.
So thank you so much for listening today and I will continue on the talking about those eight steps and eight steps of success and a core checklist and so please make this eight actions on the eight core checklist as your habit then so you can because that way you can really become successful in Atomy and so wish you all become successful in Atomy. Thank you so much for listening today.